Genesis chapter 6, verse 5
to 8.
They
are surrounded with the wicked people.
So malaetsa wa le khono ke ya re redikana ditswe ka ba gopo ba ba babe.
The wickedness
ba gopo ba bo gopo
is coming from the wicked people.
Wo utswa mo bathong ba babe ba ba gopo.
What will make the end of the world is wickedness.
Ke inga ita only facilitate mafelelong ke bobi.
So the wickedness is growing.
Ya nong bobi bo bo ya gula.
And this can make our Lord Jesus Christ to come back.
And entry kati dia uri morena Jesu abuye kapila.
It means the wickedness
ora uri bobi
affect our purpose of
bo,
life.
Bo affect morero wa rena wa uphila.
If you become a wicked person,
how to move to move?
You miss the will of God upon your life.
Ola telo akatato ya modimo odima bophilo bagao.
That God, he has no reason why he created you.
Kama njama ora modimo ana lebaka why ile anthola lefasi.
Loses his reason for creating.
Morena ola telo ka morero wa hae wa uthola wena.
Any practice of wickedness cancel the purpose of God upon you. When I read Genesis 8:20-22, the Bible says it's appointed for men to live once. After that judgment will come. The life we are living here, we are still going to speak it out before God. God is still going to judge us. It is appointed for a man to live once
from their judgment.
Days are still going to come. You were born, one day you will die. If you have got a birthday,
if you want a little church, but a little church, la matualo,
you'll be a dead day.
What about a little church? Lele mwela lihu.
Death day.
What about a little church? Lele lihu.
So how you live your life matters.
So now, how come you hope people are going to know you don't get a hole?
So what brings judgment now?
Kingeti sangkatolo anajuale.
Is wickedness.
Kibu ubi.
From the wicked man.
What hang mutongo bu ubi.
Psalm 1.
Haribala moji Psalm 1.
If we start to read from verse 1.
Verse 1.
If you fail to identify the wicked, the wicked,
they
are not stereotyped. They are like other people who have been given a choice. It is only the wind that affect their decisions. The wind is a temptation. When Satan tempted them, they disobey the laws that have been written. They do other things contrary to their standpoint that they've been given. They can be carried by the wind. In other words, they fluctuate. They can turn face there where the wind blew. They say it's tough. They face the sun. You are not a Christian when you are failing to overcome temptations.
No,
Christian, after you are challenged by the wind of Satan and you are able to stand your ground. Your standpoint in the things of God, in obeying his word, is based or checked after you've been tempted. If you are disobedient, in God's word you are the wicked. To be the wicked is not to kill someone. It's not to hate someone. You know, you are checked by what you have learned. Listen, your judgment start to be applied on what you have learned. What you have learned
bring temptation.
That temptation you must overcome. I don't know if you are hearing
The wind will come to search for what you have learned. And when you pass,
you're
obedient.
When
you
fail,
you're wicked.
When you're wicked,
punishment will come to you. Whether you confess or not, punishment will come to you. Perishing is a way of wicked. And from there we search for them. And they don't find them. When the wind blew, they disobey God's word. They obey when things are okay. When challenge comes, they fail to prove that they are Christians. The wicked are consistent liars. They normally cover their true selves. You will never know them. In other words, they are hypocrites. So you must check your friends. Because people are spirits. It is possible you live with a liar. And you will answer liars. And the moment you do that, you end up being a liar. Number three, they are manipulators. Manipulators are people who change everything to their favor. Whatever they do is for their own self. Manipulators, they can manipulate. They will leave you when they think you cannot afford them. Ask your neighbor and say, are you a wicked person? Are you righteous or are you wicked? If you still try to fight things, fight your way out. Yeah, manipulator. Number four. They don't have a feeling of guilt. They don't have a feeling of guilt. Therefore, they can't confess. If they confess, it's for the public. I saw many wicked people approaching the altar to confess their sins. But normally, they do that for the pastor or
someone.
There's no conviction in them. Wicked people are proud. They can tell you that they have money when they don't have money. Stop living to prove a point. Stop living to prove a point. Stop living to prove a point. It's only the wicked people who are trying to prove a point. Stop proving to someone that is smaller than you. Live your life. If you have got something, share it with someone. If you don't have, you don't have. God will remember you. I don't know if you are hearing that. They are irresponsible. In other words, they do not take responsibility of their actions. You hear a brother say, I love you so much. And say, I love you until Jesus come back. And they give you a child. And they say, I don't love you. They are irresponsible. They are responsible. The last one. They always appear when they need help. The wicked people, if they look at you, they see what they can get from you. If they can't get anything, because they don't want to share what they are having. Ephesians 6 verse 12.
By Ephesians 6 12.
Their spiritual powers
produce
wickedness. Spiritual powers that produce wickedness. Above there, they control people around us. We don't fight these people here. the actions that they are doing, these people here who are wicked, they've been declared from above them. If you read Isaiah 1, Verse 16 to 17. You've got ability. You've been given instructions. You cannot look at what devil is saying. You're a child of the living God. You're a child of the Most High God. Wash yourself. Get away from evil. This is ability you have. If you are failing to share things with your partner, wickedness will catch you up. You will have secrets. And devil will use those secrets. 1 Thessalonians 5:23. Let's change this. The church is insulted because of the wicked people. The wicked people are holding mic. Wicked people holding mic. Singing and preaching. And everybody said, church, there is no prophet, there is no apostle. Today, wicked people, we can change. If you want to change, I'm giving you opportunity to come and meet your God now. Come here to the altar, you meet your God. You know where you're going wrong. Disobedience must never be your portion. Some of you are still holding wrong integrity.
You're
a Christian, but you're not living a Christian. Say, Father.
Father.
We know as we are standing before you.
You know as we are standing before you.
We are sinners.
We are sinners.
Say, Father.
Father.
I am a sinner.
A sinner.
Today, I confess my sins.
Today, I confess my sins.
Before you.
Before you.
I want to please you.
I want to please you.
I want to live the righteous life.
I want to live a righteous life.
Forgive me.
Forgive me.
Of my wrongdoing.
Of my wrongdoings.
Forgive me.
Forgive me
of all my transgressions.
Of all my transgressions.
Forgive me.
Forgive me
of my sins.
Of my sins.
Forgive me.
Forgive me
of my disobedience.
Of my disobedience.
Today.
Today.
I accept you again.
I accept you again.
To be my Lord and Savior.
To be my Lord and Savior.
Jesus.
Jesus.
You are my Lord and Savior.
You are my Lord and Savior.
Father.
Father.
I know you are my Father today.
I know you are my Father today.
Wash me with the precious blood.
Wash me with the precious blood.
Make me clean today.
Make me clean today.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
I want to say congratulations for your salvation.